الحمد لله وكفى وسلام على عباده الذين اصطفى أما بعد. The second segment of Manners 101 relates to the importance of making sure that we lower our gaze when at the door of someone being visited or even inside the home or private space of another person. The inability to lower one's gaze in another person's private space is indeed a great folly in our society today and exists in many individuals. This habit can result in a great deal of offense being caused, and hence the need to highlight the importance of making sure that we lower our gaze when in the private space of someone else. In this regard, we have the famous hadith of Sa'd ibn Ubadah radiallahu anhu. He reports that on one occasion, Nabi sallallahu alayhi wasallam observed a man knock on a door and stand right in front of the door, such that if the door were to be opened, his gaze would have fallen directly into the home. So Nabi sallallahu alayhi wasallam had held the man on his shoulders and turned him such that either his right or his left shoulder faced the door, and the man stood away from the door, so that if it were to be opened, he would utilize his voice to make himself known and make his presence known, but not cast his gaze into the home. In another hadith reported by Thawban radiallahu anhu, he narrates that Nabi sallallahu alayhi wasallam once advised something to this effect: لا يحل لمرئٍ أن ينظر إلى جوف بيت حتى يستأذن, that it is not permissible, it is impermissible for a person to cast his gaze into another person's home until permission is sought. فَإِنْ فَعَلَ فَقَدْ دَخَلَ, if the person casts his gaze before seeking permission, even though permission is granted, it is as if you've already entered, and there's already a breach of someone else's privacy and a breach of this basic etiquette. And the last anecdote I want to refer to is the one of recorded in Sahih al-Bukhari and Sahih Muslim, where Sahal ibn Sa'd radiallahu anhu says that Nabi sallallahu alayhi wasallam once realized that a man was peeping through a hole in the chamber of Nabi sallallahu alayhi wasallam, and Nabi sallallahu alayhi wasallam had a single tooth comb which he used to scratch his head occasionally. So when Nabi sallallahu alayhi wasallam realized that this man was peeping through a hole in the chamber, he approached the man and admonished him. He said, لو أعلم أنك تنظر لطعنت به في عينك, if I knew that you were looking for so long, I would take this single tooth comb and prick it into your eye, pierce it into your eye. إنما جعل الاستئذان من أجل البصر, the only reason why permission is required before entering is precisely because of what one's gaze can do. That gaze can fall anywhere and everywhere, and as a result of that element, permission is required before entering the private space of another person. So in other words, what we are talking about is trust. When someone allows you into their home or their private space, it is an element of trust. They trust that the gaze will not fall anywhere and everywhere, such that their privacy will be breached. We also see from this particular encounter of Nabi sallallahu alayhi wasallam with the individual peeping through a hole in his chamber, that there is nothing wrong with taking offense to this kind of behavior. In our society, many of us do take offense, and rightly so. Just as Nabi sallallahu alayhi wasallam had taken offense for someone peeping into his private space without permission. So may we all learn this important lesson of making sure that whenever we visit or occupy the private space of someone else, our gaze is lowered. We do not look at what we are not asked to look at, or even even pick up anything that is belonging to the host. Indeed, the host is trusting enough to allow someone entry into their home, and caution should be exercised when it comes to occupying or being in the private space of someone else. May Allah Ta'ala grant us all the ability to realize the importance of this basic etiquette, so that we refrain from offending those around us. Wa akhiru ta'wana, alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen.